For you saw me with eternal eyes while I was yet in sin.
Restoration, healing, deliverance, testimonies with Dr. Jesus in action. You are watching Hour of Testimonies with Apostle Chibuzo Chinyere, General Overseer, OPM Worldwide.
When you climb up on that hill.
OPM.
Dr. Jesus in action.
Dr. Jesus in action.
God is here.
My name is Macy Isaac. I came to testify about this pregnancy. It was last year when we had 7 Saturdays to get pregnant.
7 Saturdays to get belle. Clap on for Jesus, everybody.
So it was one of my neighbors that was looking for a fruit of womb. She called me and said to me that she wanted to attend to this program, that she couldn't let us go. So I was saying that at this age, how can I go be looking for the fruit of the womb? So before I got married, one prophet prophesied, said to me that if I got married, that I would find it difficult to conceive. So when I remember the destiny, and I decided to follow her. On the process of the program, my menstruation came out. I was crying, say, you again. Although my husband was, very distant about the situation. So I was crying that my menstruation have came out again. So I went and lied down on the bed and was crying. So my mind got on this bangle on my hand, and I pulled out this bangle and placed on my womb, said, God, I know that you never leave me empty-handed in this program, that I have been listening to so many testimonies about this bangle that I want to testify. So I placed it on my womb and slept. When I wake up, I couldn't see the blood again.
Let's pray for Jesus, everybody. There is power in this bangle. There is power. No way to say. There is power on this bangle. Just placing the bangle on her womb, the blood ceased. And what happened again?
And I conceived.
Look at it. Are you seeing it? Wait. Just zoom there. That is evidence. Are you seeing it? Evidence. She was crying when she saw the blood. Child, this blood has come again. Child. But she had faith. She, no! This will mark the end. I must have children of my own. Now she used the bangle on her tummy, on her womb. And immediately, as she woke up, because she said she kept the bangle on her womb and slept. And as she woke up, angel has come already. And has done the things finished. And as she woke up, baby has come in. Let's go for Jesus, everybody.
OPM.
Dr. Jesus in action.
Dr. Jesus in action.
God is here.
God is here. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
My name is Lola, PC of Fable.
Clap on for Jesus, everybody.
I come OPN. I come with many sickness.
I came with many sickness.
From head to toe.
From head to toe. Sickness everywhere.
After 2 months, I enter OSHA. See, today, I did walk OSHA.
Love her for Jesus, everybody. She stands everywhere. She moves around. She doesn't sit. An OSHA.
That's a gong tech assignment. Dr. Jesus. Now, God don't restore the body.
Listen for Jesus, everybody. God has healed her. All the sicknesses are gone.
My second testimony is this, my daughter. As I get this baby belly, they come out the brain for her. Since that time, I dey cry. Say, why? If him they behave, no, they behave like human being. He don't know something for school. In the carry, last. I dey pray. I said, God, restore this brain. Daddy confess assignment, come program GRA last year. God, restore children brain.
Oh Lord, resurrect my brain.
As I carry him go there, they pray. She they pray too. The program ends. I buy big, buy person. The last exam where they take 30 people for class, it takes 6.
Never for Jesus, everybody. Before, she was taking last. But now, after the program on, oh Lord, resurrect my brain, now she took 6. Never for Jesus.
OPM.
Dr. Jesus in action.
Dr. Jesus in action.
God is here.
My name's Barnabas Udubre. I'm from Bayelsa State. My testimony goes like this. Let me see. I started worshiping here precisely 2 months ago.
He started worshiping OPM 2 months ago and he's testifying today. Clap for Dr. Jesus.
A friend brought me to this place. When I came here, there was a pain in my body for more than 3 years ago.
Pain in the body for 3 years.
When I started building my house in the village, I gathered myself and went to the village. I said I would just start the building and finish it at once. But when I took the house to lintel level, in fact, this my hand was, I don't know, I cannot raise it up, I cannot put it down, and I cannot even, I don't know.
Just because you want to build us in the village.
And the money, instead of completing the business, I used the money in curing the hand. Where the money got finished, the hand subsided. I have to go back to Yenagoa. I gathered about 5 million to go into a business. Suddenly, I was robbed. I was, foreigners took the whole money from me. Right from that time till now, I don't have anything doing.
Oh. But
when a friend took me to this place,
A friend took him to this place after he lost everything. Foreigner got his money. Sickness carried many money. So a friend took him 2 months ago.
When I started my prayer here.
The prayer assignment.
Yes, when I started my assignment, that hand that I cannot use, if I carry anything like 20 kg, that night I will not sleep. But before I finish that assignment, I don't know how the pains disappear.
Clap for Dr. Jesus.
Today now, I don't feel any pain.
Any pain?
I don't feel any pain. This hand is as free as this other side. The pain that was here before has left.
Give Jesus a clap of him. Yeah.
Secondly, today, I am dedicating a key to my core room that I've started and completed it. Come to dedicate the key.
Give Jesus a clap of him. He came 2 months ago. His business had crumbled. He was sick. But right now, God have restored. God have restored his health and God have restored him now. He has built a core room under 2 months. Kneel down. Clap for Dr. Jesus.
Dr. Jesus in action.
God is here.
My name is Beke Adiele. I'm living at number 26 Lucky Street, Ajib Estate, Port Harcourt. I want to dedicate my land.
Clap for Dr. Jesus, everybody. People are dedicating land, buying land, buying land.
There's no one like you, Jesus. There's no one like you in our VN.
OPM.
Dr. Jesus in action.
Dr. Jesus in action.
God is here.
My name is Oho Kingsley Okpara. One of my greatest achievements of the year 2014 is my locating OPM.
Clap for Dr. Jesus.
The church I was brought up, I never believed in going any other churches.
The church I was brought up, I never believed going to any other church. Let me tell you, if church cannot change, what do you do?
Even when people come to my house to pray, I will leave them. I will go to my room. Because I believe if I pray, I need and God can answer. On the 28th of December, there was no light. I stay at Rukpoko. NEPA brought light and I turn on my television to Silver Bed and I saw Daddy preaching. And the one thing that moved me was the number he displayed. He said, this is my direct number. Call me anytime, I will answer.
You are watching now. The number on the screen is my direct number. Call me now. I will pick. Not my PA will pick. I will pick. Continue.
I said, how can General Overseer display his number on television? I have not seen this. That moved me. I said, I will come. My sister told me, have you forgotten who you are? Where are you going? Don't go. I said, I will go. So that Sunday, the 29th of December 2014, I came here. And the prayer here was wonderful.
Clap for Dr. Jesus, everybody. The prayer here is wonderful. Wonderment.
So he portrayed a true man of God. I said, I will not go by. So that day, I picked water spirit assignment because what brought me here was too much. So many problems, affliction from left, right, and corner. All over my body was rashes. If I go out in the morning, while coming back, as soon as I pull my trouser, I will scratch my body.
Change.
And all over my body was rashes.
Wait, if you go out in the morning, once you come back, you don't remove your clothes. You mean to scratch?
Yes. Until I will feel severe pain and heat. Sometimes blood will come out, including my manhood.
And this is how long?
Last year, it happened. It started this 2013. Throughout last year, I've been moving from hospital to hospital. Even I've also gone to native doctor. I went to BMH, the RAS list of they said is staphylococcus. I've gone to herbalist. I spent a sort of money. 25th December 2014, I went to UPTH. I was referred the same test I carried out in other places. They said I should go to image diagnosis. I said, I'm not going anywhere. I can't spend all my money on treatment. So when I came here, and I was given that water spirit assignment.
He was given water spirit assignment.
Those rashes disappeared. But one stubborn one, the one in my mouth who refused to go off. I said, you must go off by fire.
You must go.
And also, I have been making love in the dream for years. And as you can see me, I have been urinating even while sleeping. When I was in school, I attended high institution. I stayed in hostel. When I urinate, I will watch my roommate. When they are not, I will take the phone outside.
Oh!
It was when I came to OPM, I know that urinating at a very high age is something wrong.
Something is wrong. When you are an adult, you urinate. Something is wrong.
So after the water spirit assignment, the love making in the dream and the urinating, everything stopped.
Now, when you say you urinate when you are in school, that is like how many years ago?
I graduated 2009 from Petroleum Training Institute in Delta State.
So this thing has been happening since when?
About 10 years.
10 years! I've bedwetting. Dr. Jesus removed it. Because God is here. 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 God is
here. Huh? Like I said, I came with so many problems. Another one is something used to vibrate in my body from my leg to my head. Whenever I get to my head, if I move on the road, my head will be pumping up and I will not be myself. Sometimes I will try to remove them on my head, but I don't see them. Also, cobweb.
And maybe somebody will be sick. Maybe on the road when I'm moving, when you're doing like this, people will say, what is this man? They come out. Now you know what they come out, but people will be laughing. Oh, continue.
Whenever that thing comes to my hand, sometimes I will not move my hand. My hand will be paralyzed. My leg, the same thing. But when I came here, I first spoke to Admin. Admin said I should take Dr. Jesus' assignment. And when I came, Daddy said, take Dr. Jesus' assignment. And I took. But I violated the rule. I test Admin. I also test Daddy. Admin said, repeat afresh.
When you spoil it, you have to repeat. Start from beginning again. If you spoil the assignment, you have to start from beginning.
So I took the second one. I'm telling you the truth. After marking the assignment, all the vibration in my body that tend to paralyze me, even the one that want to run me mad, everything disappeared.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Before that time, that was the time I came here, I told Daddy that they sent madness to me. Because I remember the time I was sleeping, a bed perched on my head. The bed has hand like human being. That night, I was screaming, blood of Jesus. That was when this problem started. When I told Daddy, Daddy hit hand on my head. Right from that time, that headache that used to pump my head up, left. So I want to give God all the glory for restoring me.
Nida, clap for Dr. Jesus.
OPM.
Dr. Jesus in action.
Dr. Jesus in action.
God is here.
We are Mr. and Mrs. William Obi. The next man by my husband's side is our friend and neighbor, Mr. Titus Ono. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
My testimony goes like this. Sometime in the last part of March, I visited them. Coming back to my house, as I came into my house, something entered my leg through my toes with a great sensation. I became uncomfortable. I rushed and got anointing oil. As I was applying the anointing oil, it was coming up with full force. It got to my hip and stopped. Then it started from the left leg, the same process. When that one got to my hip, the two of them began to come up again. Then they got to my head, to every part of my body. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And it became silent. But what I discovered was, my head began to expand. It was unusual. I began to have pressure. Sound was abnormal, was not normal again. I began to have severe headache, that I was pouring water on my head every 3 minutes.
Just by matching something, you know, the thing run from leg to the head. Please continue.
I discovered that something was crawling in my body, my head. I was complaining. I was scratching my head as if the thing was, you know, physical, that you can just remove it. But I discovered that I couldn't. They were there. It kept me uncomfortable. As time went on, I began to lose my memory. It continued that it got to a point, my neighbor came, I couldn't recognize him, I couldn't recognize my husband, I couldn't recognize my children. Before them, they asked me who they were. I said, I didn't know them. Before them,
Praise the Lord. When it became so bad that when they took me to hospital, I didn't know. From the hospital, I stayed with my mom. My mom was the person that was bathing me. My mom was the person that was clothing me, doing everything, feeding me. That is, if I could eat. Praise
so
the
you
Lord.
Couldn't, the attack became so bad that you can't even eat. The mother is not feeding her, bathing her, remove her clothes, bath her, wear her clothes.
Everything.
Continue. Wickedness. There's so much wickedness in the land. Please continue.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So, amidst that, I was throwing up. In as much as I was not eating, I was still throwing up. I was perceiving a kind of smell, particularly when they bring food and I would want to eat that food. As soon as I eat that food, I would start vomiting. And at the same time, I was seeing some arms from this side, just two arms like that. They were doing something like this. I will be watching these hands, and I'll be trying to grab the hands. My mom by the side will pat me on my hand, and I will draw my hand. I will watch the thing again. I will feel like going to grab that hand. My mom will do the same thing. I will withdraw my hand. Praise the Lord.
This time they are fired into the brain. I think went straight. It went into the brain. Now she's seeing things that are not there. Wickedness. People are wicked. Continue.
So my husband and my mom rushed me down to OPM here.
Rush out to OPM, eh?
And daddy prayed for me, gave me anointing oil. Mm-hmm. But by the time we came to OPM, I didn't recognize this place. I didn't know it was OPM. So when we came, daddy gave me anointing oil, you know, his usual way. He gave me a hit on my chest.
Uh-huh.
And I said, "Help." Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We were given an assignment. My husband and my mom, the next day, did the assignment here. In the evening, towards the end of the assignment, meanwhile, in the morning, my husband disappeared. That day, I was with my mom. My mom couldn't leave me alone. I became angry that she was with me. I made three attempts to leave the church, but they stopped me at the gate. I never liked it. Suddenly, I became angry. At a point, I confronted my mom. I asked her why she was following me about. Because anywhere I go, she will go with me. And I never liked it. I began to look for my husband. I didn't tell her. Until I found him somewhere there, I went and sat next to him. He turned and looked at me. I didn't know what he was doing. I didn't know he was doing the mercy prayer. I sat down next to him. Even from there, I was still making the attempts to leave the gate, but they stopped me at the gate. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Towards the evening, I just asked him, I called him, "Papa Chidera, what are we doing here?"
You see how people are bad? She started, the husband and they started the mercy prayer in the morning. In the evening, she asked the husband, "What are we doing here?" Continue.
He couldn't say anything because he was doing the mercy prayer. I didn't understand him. I expected him to say something. He looked at me and communicated with a sign. I said, "I want to me feel you." He couldn't say anything. So I stayed there. I expected him to say something still. He couldn't say anything. And I said, "Please, give me some money. I want to go and eat food. I'm hungry." For the first time.
For the first time. Clap for God, don't Jesus, everybody. For the first time. Oh, this God. This is the reason why God formed OPM.
He couldn't do anything. He couldn't give me the money. He couldn't talk. I was still sitting next to him until when it was the mercy prayer ended. My mom called me. I answered. She asked me what I would like to eat. I said yes. She said, "Would you want to drink malt?" I said yes. My husband called me. I answered. They asked what I want to bath. I said yes. So they got water. I bathed myself. I can tell you, I am fit. I can run from here to Air Force Junction. I can do anything you ask me to do. I've now gone back to my work. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Clear for the Lord Jesus. If you go to any church, the pastor say, "Before I can pray for you, pay any money." Tell the pastor, "Onyoshi, I'm proper." Kneel down. Clear for the Lord Jesus, everybody.
There's no one like you, Jesus. There's no one like you. In all the end.
Glory be to God. You just watch the testimonies of people. You are next to testify in the name of Jesus. If you have not given your life to Christ, you are missing a lot. Kneel down wherever you are. You want to surrender your life to Christ? It's easy. It's simple. Just kneel down. Let me pray with you. Repeat this after me. Father Lord, I am a sinner. I have sinned against you. And I've done terrible things against you. Forgive me my sins. Remove my name from the book of death. And transfer it to the book of life. I promise, starting from today, I will never go back to my old ways again, in Jesus' name. It's so simple. Just lay on your chest. Let me pray with you. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, Father, you said, "Lord, if my people that are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, they will hear from heaven and I'll forgive their sins. Heal the land. Heal the land of Judea today. Cleanse them. Wash them. Let them whiten as snow. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray." It's done. If you are sick or you need breakthrough, just lay hand on your television screen. Let me pray with you. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, by your anointing upon my life, I speak unto every affliction, every barrenness, every sickness. I cause right now to die in the name of Jesus. Leave this body, for this body is the temple of God in the name of Jesus. You, frustration, disappointment, poverty, right now, I command you in the name of Jesus to vacate this life now, to release the destiny now in the name of Jesus. Congratulations. So many things will begin to happen in your life. But I'm also inviting you to come and see me. It's very easy. You don't need to pay money to see me. You don't need to, there's no logistics. Just come to the church. You see the address on the screen, or you call me on my phone. I give an appointment. You come and you meet me. I'll give you an assignment. Once I give you that assignment, you do it very well. Your story must change in the name of Jesus. God loves you. Bye-bye.
Truly, God is here.
God is really here.
Honestly, God is here.
Truly, God is in OPM. I am a testimony and I am a witness.
How marvelous.
You are a faithful God. You are the same God yesterday. You are the same God today. You are the same God forever. You change it not.